like this. Have them touch the side of your hand, which is the contact point. No, the first part. So that's the first thing. So this is the first part. One, two. Practice that, okay? Now one here, the second move, and the combat application of single combat, single change, learn how to use that move as a strike. Now when we talk about striking, the same move, not as a block, but a strike. That should happen. Assuming the single, the parts of the single and double change. And so if the first thing is study things like have them touch the side of your hand, which is the contact point. Remember in single and double change in Bagua? In general, we don't turn our palm toward the opponent, right? Resist. This is a weak position here. Okay? This is a strong position there. The ideal contact point between me and my opponent is this point right here on the outside edge of the hand. Okay? So if you're pushing here, push at me here. So one hand only, please. Go ahead. Push hard. Push each other. That angle where you touch and you cut off their power. You see that? So that's part one. You you touch and cut off their power. Grab me hard as you can. Grab as hard as you can. And I don't want you even to try to torque. Now don't get hurt on it. So don't try to be Superman. Don't try to go like this and get hurt, okay? You shouldn't feel any force at all. Grab hard as you can. I feel very... I feel very, very little force. Here, for example, one. So he didn't feel how much force he feels. So this is it. Grab hard as you can. Learn that place, okay? And just so you know, it's not just him. Here, Brian. Give me the other side. Give me your right hand. Grab my throat. Hard as you can. Hard as you can. You're trying too, right?
Yeah.
He's really trying. Right? So I don't feel it, and that's why I wanted to know the first part, okay? Now, come here, Tom. Now, so that's the first thing. So this is the first part. One, two. But here, the general rule is that you feel very, very little force, okay? Now one here. The second move, and the combat application of single combat, single change, is how to use that move as a strike. Now when we talk about striking, the same move, not as a block, but a strike. We don't, to have the maximum effect, you don't put it on one line. We're going to step it in the wise and high like we did yesterday. But we change the angle as we get ready to have the play of contact, okay? Which means we change the trajectory. Do you guys know what a trajectory is? Right? This is a trajectory, right? This is a trajectory. And we change the angle of trajectory. Which means his force interprets your body, locks on your body a little bit. The point of impact, you change the trajectory angle. That should happen. touch lightly here, just enough to focus their mind. Just right, yeah. I'm surprised at you, huh? Are you okay?
I'm good.
Okay. Change the angle. He's expecting this. This, see this line? Trajectory. Right? Resistor. Am I using the right terms for that? Probably, huh, Tom? We're going to cover it. This is a warm-up. Let's start off with this, with the right hand first, and then follow with the left hand, toward my throat, pushing down, pushing the shoulder into this, so we can integrate a little bit of the kobu. Come up here. So the first drill today will be riding the guy's arm here, coming up, riding it down there like that. Okay? Now everybody can feel this with me one time. Here, man. Start off with here, grabbing my throat. If I play cut off your power, touch here, and try to move against me. If he's correct, the more I'm at here, and I'm leaning here on the guy, push hard. He's not going to be able to move it. He's almost has no power. It's not my size that's an issue. Take Jimmy over here for a second. It's the way it's touching. It's the Zoma concept. So as you go in, you make contact with your opponent. You actually are aware of his spine. It weakens him. So I'm going to lean here enough. Now push you over as hard as you can. As hard as you can. Two hands on me. Two hands on me. As hard as you can. Can I guide his spine, right? So second part here. Now you should be able to move either. Push me, grab me hard, as hard as you can. Feel that? And then I come across and around, okay? So that's our beginning Bagua technique. Come here, Matt. Feel the rest of it now. Yeah, see, right hand grab right here. So I got here. So I cut your power off, you see? Yeah. Got left hand, it's here. Two, over, two. And cut your power off there again. And then if you can, right hand grab me again. Walk around, catch the guy there, okay? Okay, next person. I feel like a right hand grab here. You see, like I look at the single change, right?
Yeah.
So I'm moving the single change. You see where I cut the power off?
Yeah.
See where I cut the power into your spine?
Mm-hmm.
Come over, left hand. Here. Over. Yep. And treat this way here. Okay, left and fellow, Steve. Are you starting to like Bagua, Steve?
I haven't practiced enough.
Yes, you did. Push here. Drop your power, see? And come behind. Oh, power there. Right hand comes out of me here. And then I'm going to walk behind you, okay?
Yeah.
All right? So here, I got one, two, three. So I see my shoulder here. I feel like your power now. Now your left hand comes at me here. Now, I'm going to step over. Cut my right hand grab. You see what I'm doing? I'm cutting off your power as I'm walking around you. Okay?
Again. Are you ready, huh?
Yep.
Keep shooting.
Give him a call. Cut for a few minutes, and then we're going to combine them together. Go to this spot we worked in a couple weeks ago. Before I go in here, just cut off this power. Look, even now I use my fingers, you know. It's interesting. You said like last week or whatever it was. I think look at my hand, see? I want you to explore different ways of cutting off a person's power. And I want to tie them together, okay? You feel something here?
Shoulder.
Oh, yeah. See? Cut his power off. Cut the power off. Cut the power off. Just different ways of cutting the power off, okay? And then we're going to tie it together. And we put it all together. Is that okay? Okay. This is not going to work so well, but instead, Kobu here. Now, see, I cut your power off here. I push at me. See how I combine it together? Is this making sense? What I want you to do, or is it confusing?
No.
I want you to use Kobun Bibles, empty full. I want you to multiple point it. I want you to feel where the person is. I want you to step into their body, cut their power off. Let me say one more thing about cutting power off. Keep shooting, Kenny. For cutting power off purposes, come here, Tony. She needs to be sized better. Thanks, man. Cutting off power, remember what you do if you don't want to use only brute force, you have to use the mind. That means nothing, we're not talking about anything mystical. We're talking about attunement of the mind to the attack. I want to feel where this pressure is, and that means I have to mess with his structure. So grab at me. I gotta feel your structure. That's what it means when I say tune with the mind. So when you do your technique, you sense their structure, you mess with their structure, okay? Does that make sense? Is anyone confused with that? Are you okay with it, Shahab? Okay, good. Kobun Baibu, empty full, vertical line, and neutralizing force, okay? Just work on those three things.
I want you to do some fundamental Bhagwa work. Particularly what I want you to know. Kobu and Baibu. From here, I want you to understand how to move around an opponent. And particularly I'm interested in, you see, and we're groups of two. Come here, Tom. I have two people helping. If you came there, if he's coming in, I want you to do some work. Well, actually, we're going to combine two things together. We're going to do the Kobun Baibu. I want you to see the effect of this of the default Kobun Baibu. I know you've had this before, but I want to put some advanced spins on it. Okay. Kobun Baibus. And as he's grabbing and pushing me, grabbing around, pushing a little bit. Yeah. You struggle, or you're sitting in a 50-50 orientation. I want you to see the difference between that and when you how you move out of it. I want you to learn the art of moving with Kobu and Baibu. Why it's important. Okay, now, along with Kobu and Baibu, let's do this. Let's feel the pressure, the force of someone coming at you with the hand angle. And if you notice here, this is going to be a weak angle. And once you find a strong angle for the hand in every position, so here would be this one, right? It would not be this way. If it's close, how would you do it? It would be this way. Okay, so it comes out or comes in. You see that? You see what I'm saying? It's an expansion and contraction. And with that, push me down. We use contraction, expansion, Kobun Baibu. As soon as you touch your opponent somewhere, I want you to control and move it. Not with a lot of force, good breath, but with ideas of before, Kobu and Baibu, neutralizing, cutting off the power, and so forth, okay? All right? Good. Now, emphasize that lesson. We have the swiveling door, you know, thing. You know what I'm talking about? What's that called? The revolving door? The pin. And so somebody's coming at you. Move around. So you feel the pressure? Pivoting around. The pressure here. Then once you get the basic ones here, just try it from try it like this. Go inside here. If you have any contact with the opponent, cut his power off right away. Just like what you're doing with me, your hands, Matt. Do it with your shoulder too, your hips, right? And on my hip, go in here. Go right there. Go behind me. Once you feel that, do these drills like this. Here, 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 here.
What time you went around?
Yeah.
that one?
Oh, yeah.
If you go behind him, and go to the next time. Yeah. Mr. Rutney, get his left hand back. Left hand back. Left foot, left hand back. Left foot, oh, right hand, left foot. There you go.
I want to see that push off his foot. Okay, okay.
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 Okay, let me shoot some. Thank you.